Hello, Patrick Walchuk here, November 1, 2022. I want to talk a little bit about the legislation that's coming in by the provincial government in Ontario, and it's the intensification legislation. It's known as Bill 23, or the More Homes Built Faster Act. Now, I don't have a lot of the answers here, but I do have a lot of concerns. So it's very frustrating for a lot of people. Obviously her as well, right? Now, with what we do know, and I've done research and I'm getting completely conflicting information on a lot of things. So bottom line is, I'm all in favor of intensification, but it needs to be done with more of a rifle approach. And I think that the province is taking a shotgun approach to it. Basically, the bottom line is that the province is saying that on any lot, you can put a three-unit dwelling on that lot. Okay, so that's let's start right there. Now, since the Liberals came into power in the federal government in 2015, immigration jumped up to over 400,000 per year, and Ontario gets about half of that. We get 200,000 of those people, and we need them. We need the immigrants. We need their brain power. We need the workers. We need their creativity, but we also need some place for them to live, right? So that's what this whole thing is really all about. Now, what the government said is they want to put a freeze or a complete reduction on the development charges of municipalities, to support the growth. Now, the Association of Municipalities of Ontario, they're concerned that reducing fees will shift the costs from developers who pay it now, by the way, and the people who buy new homes to those already paying property taxes. In other words, you and I who are not buying a house, we're going to pay more in property taxes to subsidize those people who are buying a house. The province wants to make things less expensive. They want to eliminate the development charges for the developers, and they think that they'll go in and build all these properties a whole lot faster. Now, development charges, they pay for, you know, frivolous things in the neighborhood like roads and bridges and water and wastewater and sewage systems, you know, things like that. So the builder usually pays for that. It gets passed along to the homeowner, but not now. So here's one of the concerns I have about that as well, is that they're not reducing PST on new home purchases, and they're not reducing or eliminating land transfer tax. Now, every time you buy a property, you pay land transfer tax on it. And let me give you an example about that. But first, the reason why they're not doing it, by the way, is that they generate about $6 billion in tax revenue just by charging you land transfer tax every time somebody buys a property. So if the average price of a house in Ottawa right now is about $635,000, and let's say land transfer tax is roughly 1.5%. It's actually on a sliding scale, but let's say 1.5. So the average house price, you're going to pay land transfer tax of about $9,500. So you buy a house today, you pay $9,500 to the government, the provincial government. If you sell it in 2 years, the new buyer pays about $9,500, except it'll probably be like $10,000. And if he sells in 2 years, then it'll be another $10,000. The provincial government has done absolutely nothing to qualified to earn that tax money from you. Did they go into your house and put in new hardwood? Did they put a new furnace in your basement? I don't think so, but they're still collecting these funds from you. And on top of that, they're going to end up indirectly increasing our taxes because the new home buyer won't be paying for their development charges. Now, do you want to own a house and then have a couple of triplexes on either side of you? Now, what I don't know is that they said three units on every lot. And I read one account where it said, well, what that means is that you've got the primary residence, then you can put a basement apartment in, an SDU, a secondary dwelling unit, for example, and a coach house in the backyard. And I've also read that, well, you can put up a triplex. So if you had a three-story building and you have three bedrooms, you could now have 9 bedrooms in 3 different apartments. So let me get into some of the things that are associated with that. One of the things that I've read is that they're going to throw many of the existing rules regarding singles, secondary dwelling units, duplexes, and triplex properties. Again, we don't know the details, but it's painting the entire city with a single brush. So for example, if you have a bungalow like here, nice quiet street, very common throughout Ottawa actually, on a typical 40-foot lot, you could have a triplex built there and a triplex built there. Now you've got six families or six groups of people where only two existed before, and you've got the potential for an additional six vehicles. Now, some of them, will they be parked on the street? You could have a total of 12 cars in that scenario, and this is what your street could look like with 12 cars versus two. That's if each unit is three bedrooms and two of them have cars. Now, if they're parked on a lot, right on the lot, what happens to the grass? Well, the trees and grass disappear, and we've now got pavement or concrete. So what happens with the rain and the melting snow that used to be absorbed by the ground? Well, it now runs into overloaded water drains. You can talk to the people in Glencairn about overloaded sewers and what happened out there. You're going to have more noise and more traffic on the street. Now, what happens to the value of a bungalow? Let's say it's on a street of singles, and then couple of years from now you got these two huge triplexes on either side of you. Is that going to increase your value? I'm thinking not so much. So what I'm hoping for here is that they take a more selective approach. For example, if you can do some of these things, don't put them on any size lot. Maybe you can only do this on a lot that is 80 feet wide or more so that you've got adequate parking, for example. You want parking for each unit. You don't want the streets clogged up, and you don't want to pave over the entire grass area and take down all the trees. A maximum number of permitted bedrooms. I'd like to see a maximum building height. Things that are currently in our building code, I don't think they should be tossed out. The minimum number of exposed yard space, square footage, whatever, and the coach house and the location. Do we maintain what we have now? By the way, there's a certain height to a coach house. There's a setback from the property line, that kind of thing. Bottom line is, the province needs to respect the owner's investment of their property so you don't end up with almost a ghettoized jungle of this little house surrounded by all these new rentals, and you ruin the whole flavor and the character of a street. Do it intelligently. Thank you.